mark a steady rise in Georgia's economy. Once central to the former Soviet Union's development and manufacture of weapons, Georgia has recently resurfaced as a potential player in the world military industry, with active contracts in Russia, Turkey, Germany, and even has stated the need, especially in these times, for a reliable source of oil in the Middle East. Commerce Secretary Moore, on a visit to Azerbaijan this morning, noted the tiny nation's enormous potential for oil, calling on American investors to provide the necessary funds for tapping the reserves.
In many ways, a leader from a bygone era. His beliefs are very firmly founded in Georgian orthodoxy. His political standings more in line with the early 20th century.
Would you fault him then as a politician?
No, no, not at all. Phillipe Nikoladze is all politician. He's done wonders for the Georgian economy. A brilliant tactician. It's more a question of ethics.
And ethically speaking?
Well...
Georgia, WC Georgia, October 16, 2004, 23 Oven Hours. That's pretty late in the night, isn't it? Discover President Nikoladze's secrets. CIA agents Blaustein and Madison were killed for getting too close to information Georgian President Phillipe Nikoladze needed to protect. Vyacheslav Grinko, a Russian mercenary, is closely tied to Nikoladze's secret. They have arranged to meet at the Ministry of Defense. Let's go get them.
Echelon got a positive ID on your target from the morgue security cameras. A guy named Vyacheslav Grinko.
How do I find him?
By his license plate.
And if he's not with his car?
Then his driver will be. Grab him and make him talk. Don't be afraid to use force.
Who? Me?
Grim's daughter just pulled up the schematics on the ministry. They've got a laser security grid online in the courtyard.
So I stay out of the courtyard.
Don't let them trigger any alarms at all. We still don't have any official approval from the Joint Chiefs for this operation. So one slip up and it's mission over.
All right. Let's just casually waltz over. I mean, you can't exactly see it right now, but if I put on these goggles, they're right there. Go. There's a lot of laser grids on there. And hey, I forgot to welcome you all. So, greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to some more Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell. I've played Arena so much, I keep thinking, welcome back to Arena, but it's actually Splinter Cell. It reminds me of that. Anyway, so we're just gonna, you know, just casually waltz down here because there's no rush, to be honest. This is where we want to go.
Grim's daughter just pulled up the schematics on the ministry. They've got a laser security grid online in the courtyard.
So I stay out of the courtyard.
Don't let them trigger any alarms at all. We still don't have any official approval from the Joint Chiefs for this operation. So one slip up and it's mission over.
Come on, come here, come here, come here.
What the hell? Oh.
That was messy. But yeah, we need to return to this room, so it's best if we just knock him out and keep him in the shadows, where nobody can see him. And it makes things a lot more convenient to just take out the camera as well, because it does get in the way quite a lot. Or we could just turn on the lights, to be honest. No need to resort to violence unless necessary, right? Come on, look over there. Ah, that's better. That's much better, in fact. Can you see me? Can you see me if I go here? Can you see me if I go here? Can you see me if I go here? No, you can't. Good, good, good. Okay, so the camera can't see me.
That's one alarm too many. The mission's over.
Fuck this. Really? You know what? I'm just gonna shoot this camera out. Ah, fuck it. You don't need that data anyway. Fine. Moving on. Let's just stay by the door here because, yeah. See, so these two guys that are patrolling, they might catch us if we're not by the door. So it would be best to just stay here for the time being. And here we go, down the stairs actually. And unfortunately, there are even more cameras here. If you remember the training, we're supposed to just, you know, like, keep shooting them out. But instead of that, what we can do here is... we can just use some classic old-fashioned timing and not have to destroy them or shoot them out, for that matter. And once we're under the camera, it doesn't matter where the camera is looking because it can't see us. Or if we're in the shadow, for that matter. Yeah. So that's the way to do it. I'm just gonna keep saving at every level. And this is bug with the game that, you know, every time you save, it just sort of... removes the sounds from the background. And yeah, I don't know what's up with that, but well, it's something that we have to worry about a bit. Oh, no cameras here. How nice. I'm just gonna come over into this corner and quickly save the game. So if you guys saw way upstairs up there, I'll mark it during the editing process. If you guys saw a way upstairs there, that's the way to the roof. It's still in construction, but if you do like a little bit of acrobatics and platforming, you'll be able to. So yeah, you'll be able to fetch like an extra med pack and a few bullets or something. I think it's an airfoil ring that you'll be able to fetch. Anyway, this is our exit route, by the way. You might be wondering how we get down it, you know soon enough. But there was that camera and we had to time it so that we could reach these shadows. It was not focused on us. And this part is actually pretty straightforward, there's not much to it. We also have a bottle conveniently placed here for, you know, our own gratification. Let's just stick to the shadows and yeah, that's pretty much all you have to do for this part. Where is the camera here? Oh, right there. And we can avoid the camera like this if you just stick to the shadows. And that's pretty much it. Nothing else that needs to be done here. And yeah, so what we want to do here is we want to sneak up behind this guy and grab him while he's peeing in the most undignified manner ever and just walk over into his pee. And we want to interrogate him.
What the hell?
I'm going to ask you some questions. When I think you're lying, I'll do this. Who do you work for?
Vyacheslav Grinko.
Tell me about him.
He used to be Spetsnaz. Now he's mercenary. He works for President Nikoladze.
Where do I find Grinko?
He's meeting Masse. In the elevator, by the courtyard.
Who's Masse?
Phillipe Masse, some computer guy. He has access to Nikoladze's office.
What's this meeting about?
I don't know. I swear, it's gotta be something bad if Nikoladze is willing to see Grinko face to face.
I need you to understand that we never talked.
I understand.
Good. Convince me we never talked.
If anybody finds out, Grinko will murder me!
And you're frightened of Grinko?
God, yes! Please, don't hurt me! I'm just a driver!
I want to hear what Grinko and Masse talk about in that elevator.
I'll need to deactivate the courtyard laser grid to get in position.
Then do it!
And yeah, you can pretty much just shimmy along the pipes like this. Whoops. I keep messing the buttons, really. Okay, let's go. Honestly, I'm just doing this to waste time. I mean, you don't need to do this. You can do this if you want to, but I mean, if you hang onto the pipe like this, it won't really, you know, set off the alarms or anything. So, yeah. That's practically what we're looking for here. Let's get into the shadows quickly, and let's hope that the camera isn't looking at us. Ready? And that's it. This level is still comparatively pleasurable as compared to the older levels. Now, right now we've got a problem here. This guy is standing right in front of us and he won't let us go anywhere without, you know, well, doing his thing. So what we need to do here is we need to take this bottle, the bottle which I just picked up, you've also got a spare bottle right here, and we need to aim it using the E button and toss it somewhere far away.
I think I heard something.
And we want him to go and investigate. Yeah. And we just want to be wary of this camera and open the door and move in. Be a little hasty about it. We do not want to waste time doing this. And that's all. And we've got another camera here which we can easily deal with. No biggie.
It's probably not my problem.
You got that right. Oh, we could have... Damn, we could have snuck away. Too bad. Too bad we did not do that. Is there another? No, there isn't another one here. So, here's the thing. If we want to, we can go upstairs. I'll just, you know, give you guys like a brief tour sort of thing. The thing is... It requires a lot of acrobatics right over there upon that pedestal that you guys can see. Yeah, you've got some rewards there. I think there's a medkit and a disposable lockpick and something else. I'm not entirely sure at this point. I think you get airfoil ring rounds as well, but I'm not sure of that either. So, yeah. So it's a little place, but it isn't exactly essential for us. Anyway, moving on. Let me unequip this and... Yeah, let's see the status of the guards. Both the guards seem to be... The guards don't seem to be here for the time being. I can just succeed and try opening the door and making an entry into this place. Now here's the problem. Where's the other guy? Huh. Not here. Actually quite strange. So here's what I can do. I can... Let me try something new. I don't want to knock this guy out, so let me try something new. Let me try shooting here.
Who's there?
Come over. That's it, come on. Yeah, good boy. And as soon as I'm in here, I'm practically safe. Or so I hope. Let me just confirm once. Unless... And that's it. Just quickly enter the place and turn off the lights, otherwise the camera's gonna get you. And if you wanna do it smoother, you can do it as well. Just be a little careful of the camera because, I mean, of course there's a camera right here. So you wanna be a little careful of it. So I guess we didn't have to knock out the guy in the first chamber either. Silly me. Anyway, I'm just gonna save the game here.
Better if I didn't see anything.
Yep. I agree. It would have been much better if you didn't see anything at all. Oh yeah. So let me just take a chance to. Go through the data. You guys can read this. This is the map if you guys are, you know, eager to see it. This is a picture of the badass Vyacheslav Grinko. Okay. So from Grim Sorted on Grinko. Relevant history. Okay. Like I said, you guys can. This would be Phillipe Masse. And damn, she's quick. Crystal Ninja, Cerber, Marvin, Kurzweil. Nice. Canadian. Anyway, so here's his relevant history. You guys can pause if you want to read. Or just, you know, forward if you don't. And yeah, that's it. Back to the game. We don't have any satchels or anything at this time. I really need to pick this sword, don't I? Oh, so in case I haven't showed you guys yet, yeah, we've got this two peak option as well. And the chef comes out for a smoke. And that's...
I need a colonel down here. We're trying to get through a retinal scanner.
I passed Colonel Kabashvili on my patrol. Want me to send him down?
God, no. I hate this guy. We'll find somebody else with the land.
So yeah, this is practically how you go about this place. You won't be dropping down. Don't worry about that. And you just want this guy to return, and as he has returned, this next part can be a little tricky though, so you might want to, you know, like just, and always make sure that you're pressing down on the crouch button when you land.
I thought the kitchen was closed.
It's a special order for Colonel Kabashvili.
Ah, excellent. May I?
Please.
Thanks.
Thank you.
So yeah, just let that guy go, and what you want to do right here is simply... Actually, I'm not sure whether we wanted to let that guy go or not, but yeah. Just toss this bottle here, and slowly walk up to this edge, because otherwise the guard... These guys here. Like I said, the roots in this game are so... set in stone, practically. That is actually quite difficult. Yeah, I did not want to do that, but oh well. I guess. Yeah, so this time I'm gonna throw it a little farther. Let's see here. Let him go ahead and investigate that. I'm just going to go ahead and yes, that is exactly what I want to do. Just quickly head down the stairs here, because that is practically your best bet of ever doing anything here. And you just want to move around slowly, not cause too much of a panic. Let me just create a new safe slot here, just in case this thing goes sideways, because I'm not gonna load the game, though, no, I'm not. Yeah. So, it's just that this part of the game is extremely tricky.
Probably not my problem.
You got that right, sir. It's probably not your problem. Yeah, so you wanna be aware, because that guy keeps turning around. He might notice you otherwise. So, you might want to take it a little slow. And once here... I'm actually glad that I did that, because otherwise there are gonna be like a ton of problems, you know, like for later. But yeah, it was nice that I could do that. Anyway, yeah. So did I do make a quick save? I did. So let's try this here.
I think I heard something.
Oh god. I wonder how we figured this part out. Ah, that's all. Basically press the down button. And now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna chill here in the shadows. And not bother the other people. Deactivate the laser. Yes, of course. So, I guess our no knockout streak comes to an end, as You see, the thing is, that computer, that has got the controls for the laser grid, and in order to deactivate it, we need to get to that. But since this guy is standing here, let me try something though. I can of course try something, can't I? Using the classic distraction method.
I'm being attacked!
Fuck, not too long, but in case something goes sideways, because you see the shadows here aren't exactly the strongest, and I want them to be quite strong so that I can hide them. Otherwise, what happens in this game is, as soon as you clear an area, a room, the computer's just gonna like do a scan, and if it sees some bodies in areas with like where there is like sufficient lighting, yeah, you're gonna get caught.
You've got an incoming colonel, Fisher. Make the most of him. You'll need him conscious and cooperative if you want to unlock the retinal scanner sealing the door to the courtyard.
That's detailed intelligence.
Knowing everything is my job.
Okay, which way is he coming down from? That's what I want to know. This way? That way? Ah, that way. And I guess I should have probably... made things a little easier on myself. But then again, he's gonna just...
Come on out where I can see you!
I was about to ask, why can't we just, you know, take his eyeballs for ourselves? Can we not? You think what? What do you think again? Go on. Yeah, you don't think anything. Go on. But yeah, that's what I was saying. Like, this game is a little old and clunky. Go on, use it. And once that's done, your purpose is finished. And we just want to drag him in here. And yeah, you know, so that you don't have to use his body again. Otherwise, there's going to be a mess. I'll just knock him out. And that's it. You can pick up the satchel and read what's in it. Oh, we don't need to read. It's a medkit. That's what it is. So yeah, and beyond this area, we are about to go ahead and... I usually like to...
That's one alarm too many.
Seriously? How did it see me? I wonder. Anyway, I'm just gonna open this door, and we're gonna run out here this way quickly, as quickly as possible. Let's just stick to the sideways.
The elevator's in motion.
Make with the laser, Mike Fisher. It's mission critical that we hear what Grinko and Masse say before they reach the top.
Okay.
Avicus, why did you rip it out with pliers?
We had some difficulty with Blostein's ship. You can see fibers of muscle tissue still attached.
Nasty. Nasty.
You're in the wrong line of work to avoid getting gore on your hands.
Whatever Nikoladze does in Azerbaijan is his own conscience's burden.
You are just a tool?
You're a tool. I'm the technology. I'm the cleanup man. All the blood's on yours and Nikoladze's hands. I'm clean.
And it is?
It's what?
Clean.
Azerbaijan? Yeah, man. The operation's goddamn immaculate. Except for the files, Nikoladze insists on keeping on his own machine. You need to talk to that.
Sounds like we found the subdermals.
I get nervous when the bad guys start making blood jokes.
That conversation's going straight to the Joint Chiefs, and we're going to need more.
Nikoladze's computer.
You guessed it. Get inside his office and access that machine. Alarms aren't mission critical anymore. We're moving into Fifth Freedom territory.
Ooh, nice. And let this guy just walk past me. Nice. And I'm just gonna... Yeah, you wanna be a little soft and agreeable. And yeah, that's why I told you guys to, you know, we wanna climb this. Just a second. So that's practically why I told you guys to stick to this side, the one which we can see right here. The top left corner of the courtyard. Well, yeah. because it makes it super easy to come over on this side, because this is the only way up. You want to grab onto this grapevine and you want to climb to this end so that you can sneak in to the next level. Quickly now. What? Oh yeah, right. And here's where we want to enter and, you know, like just... We just want to stick here for the time being. This guy's gonna go over there and chat with his buddy, and that's when we want to basically try and... We've already called the elevator first, so that we don't have to bother with it a second time. Let's hope we don't get caught. Yep, smooth as butter. Up, I guess. Thank you. And once we're up there, we need to keep our disposable pick ready, because otherwise it's gonna pose a certain few problems for us, to say the least. I'm just gonna quick save the game while I'm in here. This first game, first installment, it literally wanted you to... jump through hurdles for everything that that you want to do with it. In fact, we can actually take a bit of time to... yeah. Just access the data stick here. Yeah, that's much better, I suppose. Although I guess we have to go over to the opposite end. Yeah. So you just want to be a little quick with that. You don't want to, you know, stick around for too long, because the sounds you heard in the background of the buttons beeping, that's the sound of well. Basically, a guard coming over to this side, and you just want to avoid that. So I'm just going to... yeah, come on. Oh, come on. You can do it, go on. You can, yeah, you can drop down confidently. Make sure you've got the C button pressed when you're dropping down, otherwise it's gonna be a little bit of a mess. You don't need to go anywhere, you don't need to do anything to the security camera, just rush in. Just gonna shoot it this time, because there doesn't really seem to be any other way around it. This is our exit route, by the way. It connects all the way to the elevator. Thank you. Took you long enough. I'm just gonna reload, even though it's not really gonna be all that useful. And here's where we want to get into. 572 ammo for our pistol, and we want to go upstairs. Don't worry about any enemies, because there aren't really any enemies here. And now that we're up here, what we want to do next is grab onto this pipe here, which you can barely notice. I mean, the first time around I literally spent hours looking for this thing, and we want to rappel on the wall. Too bad we can't do like an inverted rappel. And that's the computer that we need to go to. But here's the thing, this glass, it needs to be broken first. And as soon as we break this glass, it's gonna be bad news. So I guess let's get ready, I suppose. I mean, I already did save once, but doesn't hurt to save them.
Engaging hostile.
And that's sadly what you need. Okay, fine. And that's sadly I mean, it wasn't exactly a necessity, but it's better if you do that. Because anyway, this guy would have had to go, so you could have probably taken them out non-lethally as well, but yeah, I haven't really tried that. I mean, I think I did do that the first time I played this game, because I was super, you know, big on not taking people out non-lethally, but I'm pretty sure other people know how to do that, but I don't. So that's the thing. So as soon as you grab the data,
Christ almighty.
What do you have?
We just want to...
Bad things.
Yeah.
Transmitting. We need to see how far this goes.
What's going on?
Corpses, refugee camps. They've had commandos at work in Azerbaijan for weeks. How the hell did we miss this? Keep transmitting.
Alert! All men to full alert! We have an intruder in Nikoladze's office! Wake up, you bastards! I want troops in there now!
Grinko, sir. I've got three men about to brief Nikoladze's office.
Yeah, so this is one of those scenarios where the game literally forces you into an encounter. Luckily, they won't search under this ledge, even though, you know, they take up heroic poses. So you're pretty much safe here. You don't really need to bother too much. Otherwise, you would have had to kill them in a shootout.
The rest of the files from Nikoladze's computer. This stuff is going straight to the president. He might be headed for military action, and we're going to need airtight proof.
Cool. So let those guys go. I'm just gonna save the game right here. Where are these guys running? I wonder. And we just want to, you know, use this computer once again.
That's the end of it. Thank God.
What exactly is going on?
You wouldn't believe the numbers. Nikoladze has been systematically murdering his way through Azerbaijan.
And we didn't know about it.
Nobody did.
What does he want?
You can watch the news later. Rendezvous with Junior Wilkes for extraction.
Okay, so here's the thing, I'm just going to say a quick save here. Because this is as safe a place as any now. And what we want to do is...
Intruder! Get out of the way!
How did you see me, I wonder? Is there someone coming over from that side? Oh yeah, there is. Damn. I mean, we could have just switched the light off as well instead of shooting them out, but, you know, sometimes it's cooler to just shoot them out. And so we did. And we want to make a bit of haste here. This is the path that we want to follow. And run and never look back. Because if you look back, you're going to get hurt. Now, there might be a few other people down here. Right now, I can't see anybody. That doesn't mean there isn't anybody down here. You can stick to the shadows to feel safer if you want to. It's...
Nikoladze's office is clear. We're heading for the rear gangway.
I want an uptick. Why hasn't the intruder been caught yet? Do we have men on the real stairwell?
About to breach the stairwell, sir.
So we want to make a run for it now. And don't worry, these guys aren't fighting us or shooting at us. I don't know how that guy in the end watches us, but he can somehow see us. The cameras are down. That's nice. And this is our guy. Don't shoot him.
What the hell did you find in there, man? Lambert's flipping out big time.
What's he saying?
That we're going to war.
This mission is actually shorter than I remember it to be. Okay, Georgian Defense Ministry, Tbilisi, Georgia, October 17, 2004, 0051 hours. It seems like each mission takes like 1.5 hours for this guy. Files retrieved from President Nikoladze's computer reveal a campaign of terror against Azerbaijan. Covering their invasion using techniques of information warfare, cells of Georgian commandos have nearly overthrown their oil-rich neighbors. This intelligence has opened the door for NATO intervention in the Caucasus. Caucasians. Caucasus. Mount Caucasus. Mount Caucasian. I guess. Anyway, that's just me rambling. Oh, so that's where Azerbaijan is, underneath Russia. I actually want to go just traveling to Eastern Europe one day, looking at all the Slavic countries and, you know, like the Soviet countries, including Russia and Kyrgyzstan and Azerbaijan and Georgia, you know, like even non-European Soviet bloc countries such as that. And yeah, I just want to take a look around and see how they are, how they aren't. I mean, let me know if you guys tell me. I want to know where all you guys want to go, if you even do want to go somewhere, that is. I mean, if you want to stay hold up a new place, that's your call. No judgment here. But yeah, so thus far, as it turns out, like, basically, Grinko and Nikoladze have been, you know, like, colluding, if you will, to sort of eliminate people by the millions. And that's what we figured out in this level. And yeah, so right now we don't exactly have many leads as to what's going to happen, but this information will be going to the president, and he will be deciding on the course of what to do next. The president of the United States of America, of course. Anyway, but so yeah, we have progressed thus far in the story, and we don't have any leads yet. We will have the lead in the next level, and you'll get to know about that lead when the level starts. So until that time, farewell, fellow Earthlings. Greetings and take care. Until I see you again in the next video.